Hello and welcome to Design Optics Fast. My name is Mark Nicholson. My background is in optical design and specifically in the software used for optical design. The optics industry has given me a great career for over 40 years, and now I've retired, I want to pass on some of what I've learned along the way. I was CEO of Zemax for many years, and I have experience building optical systems, teaching optical design, and helping develop new optical design methods. So I set up Design Optics Fast, a YouTube channel dedicated to teaching 21st century optical design methods. There'll be lots of short, easily understood lessons on how to design real world optics real fast. Please come and join me. Now, what do I mean by 21st century optical design methods? Well, we now have access to incredibly fast computers and software. And we don't just do things in the way that the giants of the 19th and 20th century did, but with faster calculations. The computer is more than just a really, really fast slide rule. Being able to trace huge numbers of rays, being able to optimize these systems directly for real-life physical parameters that you can actually measure, and being able to do production simulation are all 21st century design methods. Truly, we stand on the shoulders of giants, and we now have tools that not only let us do in seconds and minutes what they did in months and years, but also to do things that were undreamt of back then. Naturally, given my background, my software of choice is Zemax OpticStudio. This channel is independent of Zemax, however, it's my own channel. Also, when I was at Zemax, I felt constrained to help customers do things in whatever way they wanted to, even if I didn't agree with their design approach. This channel lets me be more prescriptive and certainly more opinionated than I could be when I was running Zemax. I want to focus on the computer-based design methods that are used in optical design in the 21st century. And I don't see this being taught elsewhere. So I want to show my approach and help you to get the best results possible in the shortest amount of time. And I put so much emphasis on fast because I see optical engineers under more pressure to deliver more designs more quickly than ever before. I once asked a large group of customers what they wanted in the development of Zemax software. If they could only have one thing, would it be faster, better, or capable of things it can't currently do? The biggest single group voted for faster. So I'm going to focus on the things that help you design optics fast. Now, it'll really help other optical engineers like yourselves to find this material if you subscribe to the channel and hit the like button on any videos you think deserve it. In return, I promise to help you design optical systems more quickly by focusing on how to set things up optimally. A little understanding of what's going on under the hood goes a long way. There are many ways to set up a system, and I want to focus on the most effective methods that make best use of your time. Keeping it simple, 10 to 15 minutes per topic isn't long, so I'll focus on key concepts. I want you to be able to take away something from each video in this collection. Keeping it physical, you'll hear me say many times that to use the software well, think about what you'll do in real life, be it in the test lab, on the factory floor, or with the product in use by your customer. Who are these videos for? Well, anyone involved in or learning the design of optics-based products, and especially anyone trying to bring a product to market for other people to use. The less expert your users are, the better you need to understand their needs and express your designs in ways they can use. You also need to take your colleagues in multiple different engineering disciplines into account. There's room here for everyone from students to optics specialists and other engineers who need to interact with optics in the products they make. What I won't be doing, any detailed derivations or handling lots of theory or giving you the history of optics. Instead, I'll just state the theory needed at the level a practicing engineer needs it and give references for those who want to check it out for themselves. As far as the history of who developed what and when, I'll really not cover much of that. The history of optics is its own area of study, and we do indeed stand on the shoulders of giants. What I will be focusing on is helping you understand computer-aided optical design, the domains of validity of the various capabilities of the software, and when to use them. Specifically, I'll point out the limits of validity of everything we talk about, so we achieve the no-surprise design, a design that should perform as well in real life as it does in the computer model. Now, no surprises is one of my personal mottos, and it has served me well in my career. You really do not want your learning to be done on the shop floor, surrounded by a defective product. That's why at Zemax they use the phrase virtual prototype. It's moved on from just being a computer model to something you can really trust and rely on, so there are no surprises when you build the real thing. This channel's a work in progress. I'll be adding a lot more content in the months to come. Please like and subscribe to these videos. And if you want notification of when new videos are added, just press the little bell icon. Let me know in the comments section what kind of topics you'd like to see me cover. And finally, thank you. Thank you very much for watching.